Thanks for stopping by WPTZ.com or checking us out on the mobile app. I'm Caitlin Napoleone. Got a whole combination of things going on over the next several days. First, we'll enjoy some sun in between the clouds and cooler temperatures, but it gets a lot more complicated from there. Starting tomorrow morning, a coastal storm will move from the south to the north, bringing us kind of a variety of different types of precipitation over the next several days. We'll see rain, snow, and a mix possible, maybe even some freezing rain, again, starting tomorrow morning from south to north. First, though, we should enjoy one nice day, even though it's going to be cold out. Highs only in the mid to upper 20s by this afternoon with a mix of clouds and sun here or there. And then overnight, some more clouds build in. We will start with a nice mild morning, technically, because temperatures from this afternoon to tomorrow morning won't necessarily drop a whole lot. But then in the afternoon tomorrow, we're going to see that crazy, crazy weather happen. It starts off with sleet, perhaps some snow to the south, and then that'll begin to lift north, and then it'll eventually turn to some rain, but also seeing a mix of things in between there. So this is what we're going to do here. We're going to break it down just a little bit. It gets a little bit complicated, so bear with me. Low pressure system to the south of us by tomorrow morning. It lifts to the north over the next several days, and as it does, we'll see rain, kind of a sleet start tomorrow, turning to rain by the afternoon, and then into Wednesday, the freezing line is going to be right across our area. So those to the west, especially in northern New York, are going to see the best chances for the highest accumulation of snow, while those to the east are going to see mainly rain, but don't be surprised if some sleet or snow mixes in as our temperatures drop overnight and then warm up again in the afternoon, pretty much for Tuesday and into Wednesday. Again, elevation will also be a factor when it comes to this storm. So when it comes to the precipitation for those to the east, you could see higher elevation, see more of a snow event as opposed to the rain. So we do have a couple things going on here. This is our winter storm watch. It starts tomorrow morning at 7, and it carries over into Wednesday afternoon at 5. And that is the concern with the combination of precipitation that we're expecting over the next couple of days. Here's your futurecast. Today, a mix of clouds and sun, and then more clouds by this afternoon and evening. Starting tomorrow morning, especially to the south, a sleet or a snow mixture more scattered in nature. As the day progresses and that storm lifts to the north, it'll most likely turn into a rain situation. So Tuesday, best chances for the rain, and that'll continue and become more widespread throughout the afternoon and evening. Higher elevations in the Adirondacks will start picking up some snow, perhaps even in the Green Mountains, and then that becomes a mainly snow event for them as we approach late Tuesday into early Wednesday. And that's actually when we're expecting the heaviest of this precipitation to occur. And again, those to the east are especially expecting it to be mostly rain, unless you're one of those folks that are in those higher elevations. Wednesday, things slowly start to taper off, but we are expecting some lingering precipitation. Rain or snow is possible. Here's what we're expecting when it comes to our snowfall. We could see above 6 inches for those in the northern New York areas. For those along the Champlain Valley, 4 to 6, maybe even a couple spots, a little bit more than that, and just to the east of there, around 1 to 4, perhaps, for some of our northern, or for our New Hampshire folks. It's going to change here, even in the next couple of days, because it gets a little bit complicated, depending on the exact track of that low pressure system. But we'll, of course, keep an eye on it here over the next couple of days. So along with the precip, temperatures in the mid-30s over the next several days will slowly, perhaps, start to see things dry up just a little bit for Friday, and then maybe seeing another chance for precip by the weekend and possibly even cooler temperatures than these mid-30s that we're showing. Again, we'll keep an eye on the things that happen here in the next several days, so stay tuned to WPTZ and WPTZ.com as this storm progresses, and we'll keep you updated. Well, thanks for stopping by our website. I'm Caitlin Napoleone. Have a great Monday.